You are now watching The Queen Chioma. So hey guys, I'm back with another video. So tonight's video is yet again another Chioma Chats video podcast edition. So by the title, we are going to be talking about the Kardashians, the culture vulture Kardashians, and their hypocrisy towards their friends. Now you guys are probably like, Chioma, we do not care, but I feel like there's some good commentary to be made about this situation. So recently, Larsa Pippen, who is the ex-wife to NBA legend Scottie Pippen, as well as a former friend to the Kardashians, and let's be real, she's an old hoe. She did an exclusive interview in which she talked about her past dealings with Tristan Thompson. Now, Tristan Thompson is the baby father as well as boyfriend to Khloe Kardashian. And as you guys know, back in February of 2019, there was a huge social media scandal between Tristan Thompson, Khloe Kardashian, and Jordyn Woods, who was the former friend to Kylie. And you guys know Kylie is technically a part of the Kardashians. So the reason why I wanted to talk about this is because I find it very odd how these women like to operate, even though they steal the aesthetic of Black culture, Black trends, and Black men, if we're being real. But then the way how they did their Black friend Jordyn Woods in regards to this situation versus how they did their friend Larsa Pippen is completely night and day. So I'm gonna play the clip of Larsa Pippen speaking about her past dealings with Tristan Thompson, and I'll come right back with my commentary.
Tristan, now, you said you brought his name up. I wouldn't do anything. I wouldn't ruin Khloe's relationship. There has been a lot of stories in the news saying that there is this rumored relationship. Can you clear up those rumors for us? Was there ever anything?
Well, I kind of was seeing Tristan before Khloe or any of them even knew he existed. I was seeing him. I had him come to LA. I brought him to a party Kim had. I introduced him to all of them. And then a week later, maybe 10 days later, he started seeing Khloe, which is fine. I don't even care. You know, it's just whatever. Like, I don't care. I'm the type of person, I don't chase what's not for me. I will never chase a man. I will never, like, put a leash on a man. I don't do that. I feel like, let you be great, you know? And if you want to be other people, go ahead. I'm great by myself.
Did Khloe know you were seeing Tristan or dating him?
Yeah, I'm sure she knew. I brought him to an event, you know, one of Kim's events. Yeah.
You guys weren't like exclusive or anything. It was just like, hey, just having a good time.
Yeah, we were just.
Beyond the first time you had a relationship with him, there was never a second time. That was it?
No. But it's funny how people think, like, I'm the most honest person in the world. Like, trust me, I would never lie about something like that. No, I knew him before Khloe even knew he existed.
How did these rumors come up? That's my thing. Like, I get it. I've been in entertainment journalism for a long time, but I feel like when rumors are so fake, like, how does that even happen?
I have no clue to be. I think it's, you know what? It's very easy to, ever since the Jordyn thing, it's very easy to be like, oh, this one's doing this to you. This one, like your friend's this, you know, your friend is doing this. It's so easy for fans and people to say like, oh, your friend is doing this, or, you know, it's just ever since the Jordyn thing.
So as you can see here, Larsa Pippen, for whatever reason, is going on this tour of talking about this situation. To be honest, if she didn't care and this situation is so old, I, for the life of me, cannot understand why she even brought it up. Tristan and Khloe are together in their toxic, tumultuous relationship and probably are going to be together for God knows how long until Khloe knows her worth and realizes that she shouldn't be with somebody like Tristan. But to speak on this, even though these are your past friends and you don't talk to the Kardashians anymore, you're not friends with them, I just don't understand. It seems a bit bitter, and it also comes off as very attention-seeking to me. But the real tea in this entire situation is, as you guys know, Jordyn Woods was the one who took the fall and the fire for everything dealing with Tristan Thompson after a alleged kiss between Tristan and Jordyn. I made a video about this back when it all came out, and yes, I agree that Khloe did have a reason to be upset with her boyfriend, being that if they were in a committed relationship, a commitment with loyalty and respect should have been there. Although the Kardashians have stolen each other's men from so many different women, especially Black women, I feel like in that situation, Khloe did have a right to be upset, because at the end of the day, her boyfriend slash child's father was out cheating, and any woman would feel some type of way regardless of their situation and regardless of their past actions. Let's just keep it real. But the way how Khloe and the entire Kardashian clan, as well as some people on the internet, tried to antagonize and attack Jordyn as if she was the one who stepped out and she was the one who asked Tristan to be with her is beyond me. Literally, they allowed this girl to become a field day for the media, a field day for their fans, and basically put her on the chopping block to be dragged by the entire world. But because we understand that the Kardashians are a certain way and they operate with loyalty only amongst themselves, most of the media, especially black media, did come out to defend Jordyn, because at the end of the day, to me, a kiss is cheating, but a kiss is not a big of a deal for them to do what they did to Jordyn, especially if whatever actions were not driven out by Jordyn. The story goes that Tristan kissed her, and the story also goes that Tristan and Chloe were not together. Now, to be honest, if it was me and I was Jordyn, I would have never still proceeded with doing anything with Tristan just because of how their family is and how much backlash I could have gotten. But let's be real, Jordyn was 21 years old. A lot of young girls make that mistake, and I'm pretty sure she's learned from her mistake and has moved on. Jordyn has seen so much more success after distancing herself from the Kardashians, and I feel like it was actually a blessing in disguise for her. Ever since that situation, her being labeled as Kylie's sidekick or Kylie's best friend has pretty much been eradicated. She's her own person, her own brand, and now she has gotten so much more brand deals, followers, and just good press just from distancing herself from the Kardashians. But with Larsa, it seems like the Kardashians either gave her a slap on the wrist or just quietly went about their business and not dragging her and bashing her. And I find that to be very weird that the black girl was the one who was basically crucified into the media to be dragged, even though it backfired on the Kardashians. And this white woman, or whatever Larsa is, someone who was a non-black woman, is sitting here basically got away scotch-free. Even though Larsa did admit to messing with Tristan prior to him and Chloe getting together, I still find it weird that they just quietly unfollowed her. They didn't make it a big deal. They didn't throw any subliminals, and they didn't subtweet her or use her as a storyline in their show. That's very weird to me. My thing with the Kardashians is I feel like they're running out of relevancy. People kind of see them for who they are. They are culture vultures. They do take things from every culture. They do try to use other races and other cultures' aesthetic to build their brand. And although I am one for unity amongst all people, and I do feel like everyone bites from each other's culture, the way how they try to profit off of it and the way how they try to act like they're just victims and these people that don't do anything wrong is beyond me, because many times we've had to call out each and every one of them for doing something that was a little bit too absurd and disrespectful to black women or black culture. Larsa did not receive anywhere near the same backlash as Jordyn got. And maybe it's because they were more likely her friends, or it's because she's an older woman or whatever, but still, it doesn't make any sense to me. Jordyn came off as a very loyal person to the Kardashians, and even with her post interviews about the situation, she seemed very remorseful, very guilty, and very willing to just correct her wrongs. And I don't feel like Larsa is even doing that in this situation. Now, does Larsa have anything to necessarily be sorry for? No, she messed with Tristan prior to Chloe messing with Tristan. But I just find it very weird how this is being maneuvered. Like, why was the black girl dragged for the filth? Why was the black girl basically crucified into the media with the hopes that she would become nothing? Jordyn literally revolutionized her career, and this couldn't have been any better for her in the long run. I know it probably hurt for her to be dragged, it hurt for her to be embarrassed, and it probably hurt to be humiliated, especially off of a situation that she did not cause herself. But let's look at the big picture here. Why do women always blame the other women for things that men do? The amount of women that have this like emotional tie to guys to defend them in their wrong actions is beyond me. Here's a little story time. I was dealing with this guy pretty much the beginning of 2020 up until the summertime. He ended up doing me very, very bad, like extremely bad, to the point where I had to take a break from YouTube. I was very depressed, and I really had to pick myself back up, because being played the way how I was very off guard and very hurtful. Now, there were some things that occurred after our situation that needed to be taken care of, and I had this interaction with his mother, and his mother literally was defending all of his actions, sugarcoating how he treated me, as well as not offering any form of sympathy even as a woman. I understand defending your child and your son, but the way how she seemed to have no care in the world for what her son did, to me was very appalling, because we as women go through a lot of the same things. Heartbreak, embarrassment from men, being cheated on, being lied to. And I'm not saying women don't cheat and lie. There are a lot of manipulative women out there. But in this situation where I feel like I didn't do anything wrong, or the things that I may have done wrong were not at the magnitude that this guy's actions were, there was no accountability even coming from his own mother. And I see this a lot with women. We like to sit here and blame the girl. We like to sit here and crucify the girl. Oh, you knew he was married. You knew that he was in a relationship. You knew that he had a girlfriend. So did he. Tristan knows all of these things, and Tristan has his own actions. But we see Chloe on Keeping Up with the Kardashians, which I don't even watch anymore, using her storyline, talking about how she's trying to rebuild her relationship with Tristan, how she's trying to rebuild her trust. And it's like, you did all of this, dragged this black girl, made her feel worthless, embarrassed her, tried to literally ruin her entire career just to end up back with the guy that actually embarrassed you, stepped out on you, and all in all had a commitment commitment to you. Jordyn did not have a commitment to Khloé. Her commitment was to Kylie, as that was her best friend. And although she should have respected Khloé as Kylie's sister, there was no loyalty that was owed. And although I still feel like it was wrong for there to be any interaction between Jordyn and Tristan, nobody's blaming Tristan. Larsa's not blaming Tristan. Khloé's not blaming Tristan. Jordyn was the only one holding Tristan accountable for his shit, which she should have because she was the one being demonized in the situation. I say all of this to say the Kardashians are falling out of relevancy. They're using any little bit to upkeep their entire relevancy. And I feel like Larsa is actually a part of this plan. There's no way that Larsa would just come out and talk about somebody who she claims she barely was dealing with. She saw him. They were seeing each other for just a little bit. There's no way that she would care this much if she wasn't benefiting from it with a check or with some form of notoriety. And that's how I feel about the entire Kardashian clan. I just don't like that they're trying to make their pockets bigger or gain recognition or maintain their relevancy at the expense of a Black girl. This situation is almost 2 years old. Why is it there's still tweets being thrown, interviews being had, storylines being dragged on? I predict that the Kardashian show is going to end within the next year or two. We just don't care anymore. And I feel like people are starting to see them for who they really are, which is their own cult or culture of their own clan. Meanwhile, behind the scenes, I feel like they're very strategic. They don't really have any loyalty in their ways as it comes to their promotion of themselves. And protect the brand by all means, but the shiesty behavior behind the scenes is very, very, very not cute. The Kardashians are played out to me, and I just don't like the fact that Jordyn was drugged and Larsa is sitting here with a slap on the wrist. All they did was unfollow her. Nobody dragged her. Nobody threw shots at her. Meanwhile, the person that does deserve the actual scrutiny, Tristan, is walking away scotch-free. He has his girlfriend back, and all the other girls in the situation have to sit there and look stupid and humiliated. Be very careful with who you call your friends, especially some of these big name people with blue check marks and TV shows and followers. Be very careful because they will definitely sacrifice you to save themselves, their brands, and their reputation. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know your thoughts on my commentary down below. Don't forget to follow me on all my social media networks, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.